Okay, there we go. Now I think I'm in business. I don't know why the soundboard was disabled there as the main sound, but I think I got it figured out. Now, if you can hear me, somebody say, hell yeah, Saturday. Saturday night, something like that. Throw that in the comments there so I know you hear me. I would appreciate it. Then we can get rolling. Hopefully I can cut the first 7 minutes of this off when it goes to video. I think you can hear me. Okay, I'm hearing game sound.
For me. Somebody say, hell yeah, Saturday.
Okay, I can hear me. We're good. All right, let's play some football. Hello. Welcome to the UMass Dynasty Live. Now a live stream only series. Picking it up here. Because it's fun to play and not so fun to edit when I'm editing all new games and, you know, going back to NCAA 13 to edit. Yeah, not so fun, but it is a great thing to do when I got a chunk of time. Like tonight, the kids are not here. No interruptions, really. So I got a chance to play some football with you guys. So glad to have you here. Let's just fire into this game, shall we? I was hearing game sound. Is that were you hearing game sound?
Picking it up here because it's fun to play and not.
I don't know. I'm not gonna worry about that. We're just gonna get going. Uniform options. We don't have a lot here in 13. UMass had much better uniforms in NCAA 14, which is one reason why I wanted to do the changeover. But just too much work to get my roster over. Just for a few upgrades. It's so much easier to leave it here, especially when I like the recruiting better in 13 anyway. So I'm not going to go all red. Let's go with that maroon and black look. That's probably my favorite look for home games. That's working for me. Okay. How's everybody doing tonight? You enjoying your Saturday night watching the tourney? Had our first number one leave the dance in Villanova. They just got beat. I don't have a horse in the race this year. Minnesota couldn't even make the NIT, so I'm just kind of a bystander this year, just enjoying the tournament as it is. Can I bring back SGU gamers? Yeah, that's something I definitely have thought about since, you know, we're not really getting a new NCAA game. That, you know, I probably can still play that and edit it up. But, you know, the truth of the matter is we're going to be bombarded by baseball soon here. The channel is going to be, you know, a legit 75% baseball when the 31st hits here. Because it did very well for SGU last year, and I'm hoping it will again this year. In a minute's notice, get a spotlight on Andy Chase as we come in here. Take the field in Amherst. Spotlighting the defense. He's just a sophomore. How about that?
It ought to be a great one tonight, and we are glad you're with us. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready to call ESPN's college
got
football.
A big-ass glass of ice water that should help my voice through this.
The university founded in 1863 and now home to 27,000-plus students. Hi, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler, and I'm with Kirk Herbstreit here in the booth.
Okay, so for those of you who haven't followed along, we moved UMass, I believe, to oh my God. Sorry, I'm watching the Minnesota-Michigan hockey game right now for the Big Ten tourney championship, and one of the Gophers just got absolutely lit up at center ice. My God. Yeah, so I moved UMass into the SEC for this year, I believe. Since we won the national championship last year down to Michigan State in that championship game, taking out the player we were spurned by, the player who turned us down, Cam Slinger, relative of Sam Slinger. And we took him out in the national championship game. How cool. I couldn't have even scripted that. It just happened that way. But, I mean, that's pretty much what I would have scripted out in year five. It was amazing. Did I do a bracket? I did one bracket on ESPN. I usually fill out four or five. I just wasn't feeling it this year. I just did one. It pretty much got smashed when Iowa State went out. I had them go into the Final Four, so already one of my four Final Four teams out. I had Villanova losing in the Sweet 16 round, though, so that one didn't hurt me too bad. I've got Kentucky winning. I mean, surprise, surprise, who doesn't really? I mean, you know, unless you're just playing odds that somebody will knock him out. I believe I have Kentucky, Virginia in my championship game. I went Virginia's route.
There's been an upset. The Beavers take the win, 24-10. Meanwhile, the Broncos.
All right, see some of the scores going around the country here. Boise State gets a win. Virginia Tech loses.
And for Graves, fires two touchdown passes.
All right. Let's see if we can get things going with our speedy running game here. If we can get our guy outside. Now, I noticed Auburn is not ranked. Normally, we face off with Auburn, and we had some good games in the past. As a matter of fact, I think we had one wild one with a missed field goal that was returned for a touchdown on our end. That was pretty awesome. I can't remember if that was in year five or year four, but it was somewhere in there. When's the next Cubs franchise video? I played it. I need to edit it. I'm hoping for that tomorrow. Slated for tomorrow. Let's put it that way.
From their own 30-yard line, it's second down.
Get this running game going a little bit here. I hope. Run him over.
And he hits him hard at the 33-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
There was simply no
third and two. I should have confidence that we can get this on the ground. I don't want to go three and out, though. Let's see. Let's get a fullback in here.
Third down, two to go. Ball on their own 33. They stack the line of scrimmage here. Let's see who's got the stronger lineman.
There you go. Vincent quick through that hole, and we got a first down.
The offense here picks up a first down by
it's just run, pass.
Hey,
there's nothing like an effective running game. You can wear it on the clock and run the football, and they can't stop you. That's a good feeling. We are going to try to hit them with some play action here, maybe, though.
First and 10.
This is interesting for me to do this way because, you know, normally I just cut down to highlights, but to actually go through play calling and all that's kind of fun. Keep that short. Oh, he knocked it away.
Jones, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
What happened to my overlay graphic? I had an overlay graphic all set up for this that I used last time. And it's not there. I'm not going to mess with it right now, though. Because it's not that big a deal.
Second down, 10
I think I must just have it checked off on XSplit or something. Maybe hit this running back out of the backfield here. If they blitz. Oh, they were right on him, though. That didn't work.
So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was that
didn't work. Face cam. Yeah, no, I don't really have my lights set up that well in here. It's awfully dark in my office right now. Office slash bedroom here. Oh, I forget what my go-to plays are. Let's see here. I know I like hitch corners. I've recruited well at wide receivers. I like my chances. My wide receivers, let's see what I can get here. Are they going to play off you? Oh, I jumped it. He could have. Oh, that could have been a pick six. I should have gone the other side. Did Georgia State win? No, they lost.
The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
Yeah, I guess we're going to go ahead and punt this ball away. Now, I'm used to my punter being terrible with my Chargers team. I got to be careful because I know Patton's got a leg. Try to pop this thing up, maybe.
It's away and
I left it inbounds, though. Darn it. That would have been nice, Eddie. Oh, fumble.
This would be a great time.
Our ball. There we go.
This momentum shift.
Maybe it was a good thing I left it in bounds. All right, we'll take that. Oh, they're going to review this. Oh, I'm not going to get this, am I? Was he... Let's see. Oh, we're looking at out of bounds? We're not even looking at the fumble. What are they going to call? I thought for sure they would have looked at the fumble. Yes. He stayed in bounds, which works well for us.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 21-yard line.
Try to get the outside edge here with speed. Cut inside. I know he's a little guy. I don't want him to get too hard, but that speed, though. He just got, like, the big forearm takedown right there. What do I think of Joe Montana Football 16? I really haven't seen a whole lot other than that screenshot that was circulating. Looks like another all-pro football 2K kind of game from what I saw there, or another backbreaker until I see more. I don't know. Was there more release than just that screen that I saw on Twitter? I'll get more excited when I see more of it, I guess. Man, they're bringing some heat there. Okay, that's how we're going to play. Whoa. Empty net time for the Gophers are up 3-2 in this hockey game. And Hudson Fashing just got absolutely destroyed. He was going for an empty net goal, and he got destroyed into the boards. That better be a penalty. I'm conflicted here because this is my two favorite football. My two favorite colleges going out of here, Michigan and Minnesota. Of course, I got to root for Minnesota when these two play each other, though.
About 4 yards away here on third down.
Looking for Wesley, my tight end. Let's do this. Oh, they jump or did I jump? Come on.
Here's the call from the head referee.
Encroachment. First down. We'll take that.
In a game like football, if you keep
they're helping us out here. Fumble. Oh, there was a development video. Okay, I'll have to check that out then. I had not seen that. All right, so we got first and goal. I'm going to try to catch him. I don't want a shotgun screen, though. I want under center. Come on. This playbook might not be what I want. Whatever.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Yeah, I'm going to have to do it out of the pistol here, I guess. Get out there. Nope. Too slow developing.
He's knocked out of bounds at the five.
These short, effective passes are going to help the
quarterback's confidence. Am I sick? No. I had a little bit of crud on my throat. I've had that going on for like a month now. In varying degrees. But no, I'm not sick. I always screw up option, but I always feel like I want to run option. Let's try it.
They're at the five. Second down.
This usually ends in disaster. Ah, they're stacking it over there. I'm not going to get this set up in time, am I? Come on. Come on. Nah, I just should have taken a timeout there. Too much messing around.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Am I going to make a Madden 16 wish list? You know, I'm not really much. I usually don't do wish list videos. I usually talk about that kind of stuff in videos and live streams and stuff, but I don't necessarily ever make a legit video on them. It's usually just not really my thing, but there we go. Empty netter for the Gophers. Big Ten hockey champs, whatever that means. God, I'm so pissed they broke up the WCHA is how it was. Cut, cut, cut. Touchdown. There we go. Get on the board first. thanks to that fumble recovery on the punt.
One of the things a quarterback's looking for before the ball is snapped on a post route is to see if he has one safety in the middle of the field. Because with one safety, you can use your eyes to move that safety and then throw back the other way for the touchdown.
I should play Madden Ultimate Team. I always have played Madden Ultimate Team. I just, you know, I've gotten bored of it in the last couple years. To sustain a series, I always start one every year. But, you know, I don't know. I've just kind of gotten bored with it the last couple years. I'm not sure why exactly. It's fine. You know, it's I used to spend more time than I wanted to on collections. I loved doing collections and, you know, that aspect of it more than even playing the games in Ultimate Team. But it's so time consuming, and I'd find myself not, you know, getting done what I wanted to get done for my channel. I'd just be playing and, you know, flipping collections hours and hours on end, and it wasn't really healthy for in a YouTube sense. That's probably why I backed off of it.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
All right, time to play some defense. Our defense, on paper, I thought our defense was going to be, like, even take a step up this year. Because we've really built this thing through recruiting. But when they actually get on the field, I don't know. This defense has some issues still. I don't know if it's like the overall. He broke off the tackle and another one. Really?
He's at midfield.
Wow, that dude wasn't going down. I don't know if it's like their awareness, because it was kind of like back in the first couple years of this. They just weren't very good, and they also weren't aware. So I had both problems. But now we've got like the athleticism. Like to make nice defensive stops right there. It just seems like the awareness quite isn't there. I don't know if that's because I'm putting a lot of athletes in different spots. I don't know. I probably should turn back a tourney game back on now that the hockey game's over. I'll have to do that when I get a second here. All right, we gave up that big play, but let's get a stop here. Always going to try to run. Come on, see, right there. Right there is what I'm talking about. Bad awareness. They let him get 10, 12 yards up the field before anybody stepped up to put a hit on him.
He waited and found no one open, so instead of throwing it away, he just took it upfield for himself.
That's what I'm talking about right there, though. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, I guess we're doing a little bend, but don't break. Are we just going to see UMass only in stream? In this stream, yeah.
So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here.
That's why it's entitled UMass Dynasty. I don't do a whole lot of the streams where... Is that good? Oh, yeah, just enough. 7-3. Okay. I don't really do a whole lot of streams anymore that are just, you know, random... 6 hours, I'll play this, I'll play that. If I'm going to hop around to games, I'll start a second stream if I'm going to change a game. I like people to know what I'm playing via the title and everything. And especially this where it's an actual, you know, series I'm doing with it, even though it's live. All right, so... Running game hasn't been like terribly hot here. Let's try to get the passing game going. Well, let's just look for balance. That's what we should be doing here, right? Oh, goodbye. Oh, can anybody catch Wesley? I know he's a tight end. Gets inside the 20.
Timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful with their passing game. That time the quarterback threw it to a spot.
Big time catch by the tight end, and then they got nobody until way downfield. Look at the height advantage he's got, too. This has always been one of your favorite series of mine. Awesome. Yeah, I, you know, it is something that I really do desire to play once in a while. Like tonight, I got the itch to play it. You know, it's just, it's one of those things. It's like, really, do I want to be editing an NCAA 13 video? So, I mean, you got to kind of cut the line somewhere, but that's where live streaming, it can be a lot of fun. Oh, wow, dude. Blake Wesley's like a Gronker here or something, man. He's like, he had to undercut him just to take him down.
First down, and they come to the line with a first and goal.
They got a stack here. Let's go. Try to run off the tackle. This could work. Get outside. Yeah. What game is this? NCAA 13. Job up front by the offensive line. They get a good strong push that allowed the runner to get it in there for the touchdown. The project, long in waiting, or, you know, long in my head, was to port this to 14 via Team Builder. Not via Team Builder, because I didn't want to lose. There were several reasons I didn't want to do Team Builder. I wanted to use UMass's updated uniforms and everything they put into 14. A lot more uniform choice, a lot less generic. You could go like with the all-black look. I think they had the black helmets, all that stuff I desire to use. I love the game mechanics of NCAA 14 better, the game engine. But I hate recruiting in 14. I hate it with a passion. I've never bought into it. So there are pros and cons, and the biggest con was just you know, going in and porting all that information, like basically creating a spreadsheet. I started it once. I started with the offense, and it was just a tedious job of transferring over all this stuff on a spreadsheet, trying to get all the players in correctly. And then once you do that, then I'd have to figure out like what would be a fair level for my coach to start on. You know, we'd be starting back, you know, years back before we had already gotten through. It would have been messy.
So at the end of one, the Minutemen lead 14-3. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Oh, can he get outside? Bring him down. There you go. Gets the first down, though.
On the option keeper, but it's good for a first down.
Yeah, it didn't even look like
it's okay, just no big plays. That's all I'm asking for.
He doesn't like what he sees. He's going to change the play here.
Right side. Oh, don't let him get the corner. Yeah.
Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
What's my second favorite MLB team besides the Twins? Well, it's debatable whether they're my first. It's always been a 1A and 1B between them and the Boston Red Sox. I've always been a diehard Red Sox fan for as long as I can remember.
You know, this corner has physical abilities that you're going to see at the next level.
What's with the blue fans in the stands? Well, technically, there is blue. You can see in my color palette, if you look at my helmets, there's a blue stripe. So it is in their color palette.
Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on their own 41.
That's probably what they're playing off of.
He drops back.
Come on,
runs with it, and he's got room. He's at midfield. Tackle made right around the 40.
Terrible awareness defense. Come on. Gotta notice he's running. Padres Chargers, how you doing, man?
Really starting to work hard in the trenches.
He'll change the play at the line of scrimmage.
That's better. No gain.
About the 49. That's a loss of 1 yard. That makes it second and 10.
Jonah, if your next question is, I'm just guessing ahead of you. If you want to know about National League teams, favorites are the Rockies and Cubs.
Bring him down around the 40-yard line. So the quarterback completes the slant pattern for about a 9-yard gain.
Rockies, because I've spent, well, actually probably both of them, because I've spent a lot of time. I've been to Wrigley 2-3 times. I've been to Coors Field probably 4 or 5 times now.
He scrambles.
I've spent a lot of summers in Denver and other places in Colorado. Not like full summers, but a lot of summer trips.
Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. Right, running the option. He makes it to the 35.
Wait, did I knock out their quarterback? That's a different quarterback, isn't it? Or are they just running Wildcat? I must have knocked out their quarterback.
He may have changed things up here.
At least for right now.
And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. That's good for a gain of 1 yard.
That'll make it 35. What do I think about the Adrian Peterson situation? I'm oversaturated in it. I mean, it's really sad as a Vikings fan to say. I honestly could say I can live either way. I mean, you know what? Just get it over with, whether he's here or not. And when this first all went down, it was like, no. I mean, it's like, how could a team, you know, lose their, basically their identity like that? But honestly, I'm just so frustrated. You know, if he thinks that we being the Vikings or we being as a fan base didn't support him enough, I mean, get real, dude. I mean, I'm sorry. With you know, somebody with fairly young kids still, I just don't approve, and I don't know what the hell he expects. I mean, he put the team and this community in a really bad situation to try to have to stick up for him. You know, I mean, whatever, dude. I mean, you kind of made your own bed. So, I mean, after hearing, you know, all the stuff that happened with his agent almost coming to blows with team personnel and stuff, I'm just like, you know, whatever. Just go. I mean, just don't be a cancer here. I mean, you know, before all this came out, you know, he was supposedly, oh, you know, he's so great in the community and oh, this and that. And yeah, the more and more you hear, you're just like, whatever. You're just like every other thug out there. I mean, like I said, I'm just so, like, desensitized to it right now. I just really could care if he goes or less. You know, if he goes or not. But I would, oh, fumble, come on. There's only Auburn players around it. But, you know, in the same sense, I'd just rather have the whole distraction over with. I don't understand why people say that. He needs a change of scenery. Why? I mean, why? Because Minnesota is going to make him feel like beating kids? I mean, that's such a cop-out. It's bullshit. He needs to fucking get his shit together and not, you know, think that beating his kid with us, you know, with a friggin' tree branch is okay. I mean, what? So that's going to be okay if he does that in Dallas? I get that, but in a sense, I'm just like, I mean, what a bullshit cop-out. I mean, you're the problem, dude, not your change of scenery or where the hell you are. My opinion is just, you know, totally taking a 180 with him. And the sad thing is, I don't think that player behavior is like really changed much at all. I just think that you live in a day and age where all this stuff gets captured. You know, it shows up on TMZ or it shows up on somebody's cell phone and you don't think anyone's watching. And I mean, if you don't think that players back in the day, oh, come on, Vincent. Look at that speed, yeah! Oh, I was trying to do a Marshawn move there. I think he just got hurt, didn't he? He was holding something there. Please get up. You know, if you think these guys back in the day didn't do despicable things, I mean, just say they just didn't have, you know, people with phones in their face all day. And now he is hurt. Darn it. You know, it's just now all of a sudden society's outraged. And, it's crazy. So, it's really naive to think, oh, these players all of a sudden are doing, oh, no, he's going off on the cart. That's not good. Now, remember, He lost most, if not all, his freshman year because of injury. I think we got him back right at the end.
So we've got a first down after a great running play. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
I have no idea when the next NCAA game is going to come out. I mean, it's questionable. You know, that's a more of an if statement than when. You know, we're all going to have to wait and see if it's a viable thing that they can come out with another one. I mean, I really certainly hope so. I'd love to have a next-gen college game someday.
Here on second down.
I mean, think about that. I don't know if you guys have heard about it or not, but this wrestler that died down in Mexico last night in the ring in a Rey Mysterio match. And, you know, just thinking about, okay, if that stuff would have happened back in the day. Well, for example, when Owen Hart died and, like, you know, trying to find footage of that. Well, you know, WWE would never let that get out. I mean, you know, lawsuits and all this stuff. But, I mean, here it is. You know, this guy died in the ring. And, you know, everybody's got a cell phone. There's multiple videos out there. And I'm not saying it's good or bad, but it's just, you know, it's our society. That was a really tough place to get the ball into, but Corey Harvey made the catch.
Yeah, I think that was great determination.
But I'm just saying, something like that happens 20 years ago, and you know, it would obviously be a story, but it wouldn't be everywhere in the world in 15 minutes via cell phone. What's my opinion about the Capitals? I don't know. They beat us the other night. I'm a Wild fan. I have Ovechkin on my fantasy team, so go Ovechkin.
That he's changing things up here before the snap.
Other than that, not a whole lot of opinion. Touchdown.
And he snags that one.
This offense just has so many weapons to defend.
Do I play other games besides sports? I try to occasionally, but there's two things working against me when I play other games besides sports games. Number one, first and foremost, I just don't really have the time to sit down and, you know, just kind of play through a game like that for pleasure. Because, you know, 95% of the time when I'm playing a game, I'm recording in some capacity, whether I'm live streaming or editing for a video, which is cool because it's still games I love to play. But the second thing working against me is probably because I don't play them much, but I mean, like, I'm terrible at shooters. I'm kind of person that, you know, I love playing those games. Let's see. Bruised ribs. That doesn't sound too bad for Vincent. Bruised ribs shouldn't be, like, a big-time setback, I don't think. I hope. What am I getting at here, though? I'm terrible. Like, I love... I've never really liked first-person shooters. I've never really been one that's been that excited about playing first-person shooters. I really like the third-person type games, like the Uncharted's, like those kind of games. But I'm not good at them, and I get frustrated easily, and the combination of not having much time to do it and not being good at it, yeah, it usually sets me back real fast.
He looks to throw on first down. Going deep.
Trying to go deep. That is. Oh, they're going to call me for PI. Come on. Really? Well, at least it's college football. It's only 15.
Concentration lapse right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
Junk Johnson is not happy about it, though. Look at that. I think it's only because I switched to the guy and he happened to trip him up. I am not going to do the anniversary edition of MLB. I really don't find any reason to. All that gimmicky stuff, I never really... You know, it's like, oh, it comes in a special tin case, or I don't even know, honestly. I haven't read everything that comes with it, but it's like it really doesn't do much for me, especially when I'm planning to get the digital copy anyway. And I think it said the difference in the digital copy is you get a code to buy a skin for your PS4 controller, and I'm like, please, I'm not even going to use that.
Quick throw. He's taken down right around the 36-yard line.
Auburn trying to get those points before halftime.
And he might change the play here before the snap. Drops to throw on first down. Scrambling around. Excellent open field.
Now, is this the starter back? Yeah, I think this is the guy who started.
That makes it second and two. Auburn's a little confused. They used their second timeout.
They call the timeout at the 1 minute mark. Okay. I see that,
he's looking to pass.
I think it was today, Chris Bryant hit another two homers with the Cubs today, spring training. Dude looks like he's going to be a beast. Loving to see that, because I've got him called up, obviously, in my Cubs franchise. Notre Dame's getting blanked right now, almost halftime. We already have two losses. We need those big undefeated teams to be losing games here. I would say we have no shot at a national title, but Michigan State made it into the championship game last year with two losses, so we won't rule it out yet. Do I smoke at all? No, I've never been a smoker.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts.
Oh, big hit right there. There we go. They're wasting time getting back at it here. They run a draw on us, huh? Okay.
Nice run, and he's brought down. And the clock continues to run.
Still got 10 yards to go, though. I don't think they want to settle for a field goal here. That's really not going to help them a whole lot. But they might not have a choice.
Right around the 10-yard line.
I don't know. Are they going to go for it or are they going to kick? I feel like taking a timeout on them, but if they're going to go for it, I don't want to give them more time than they need. Field goal. Did they take their last timeout? Nope.
This one nah, whatever. Be
Auburn, we'll oh, now they take a timeout with 5 seconds left. Okay. Who do I have winning the NCAA tournament? Well, you know, you're going to love this that I went out on a limb, but I went with Kentucky. I don't know. After watching these first two games, there's like, you know, you watch these guys. I mean, even some of the big schools that, like, yeah, some teams flirted with being upset and then they turned it on. Nah, Kentucky's like, screw that. We don't even let anyone stay in the game so far. I'm not saying that they can't be beat, but show me a more solid team right now through two games.
Can forget about returning this one.
You've actually been to two UMass games? Sweet. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to risk a pick six here or fumble or anything like that. I think we're just going to run this football and be happy with our 21-9 lead. I'll take that for first half.
The Minuteman lead, 21-9.
Why does everyone want Kentucky? Now, don't get me wrong here. I'm not saying I want Kentucky to win it all. You just asked who do I got winning it, you know? I'm just saying that's a smart choice. Can I play FIFA 15? Not right now. All right, so a good first half. Look to finish us up with a good second half and try to get us a win. That's what we need is a win. We'll be kicking off for the second half here. Will I do a Madden 15 career? Yeah, I will, and I'm probably going to go back to doing something safer like a quarterback or running back. My early thought is to bring back Sam Slinger, but I might actually just, you know, create somebody new. We'll see. Will there ever be another NCAA football game? You know, I don't know. I have a feeling that at some point something will change that will allow them to do it and that they'll want to do it again. But I wouldn't be holding your breath for any time soon. It's just that, you know, it's just like where we are with, how awesome would it be if there was another 2K college basketball game? If they were able to, you know, as well as they do. Are we really going to, you know, when we already know this guy is going to run, we're going to really just give him that much room to run? I mean, that's my fault. I probably should be spying him. But, you know, how awesome would that be? A next gen college basketball game. If they never sold, you know, they lost big time money, and that's why even before the lawsuits shut down college football, I mean, even this game, you know, the Madden was a seller. This one they were losing money on, but it has a rabid cult following. Might be smaller, much smaller than the Madden fan base, but has a cult following. But I mean, they shut down college basketball games long before because they just were a money sinkhole. Really making it difficult. Possibly changing the MLB 2K needs to come back? Nah, that's okay. They can keep that crap out unless they're going to revolutionize something in the way they do it. Although I say that, but I'm all for competition. I mean, even if a game's crap and it's a, you know, secondary game on the market, I welcome it. You know, I always liked 2K as my change of pace game in not only in baseball but in hockey too when they made it. I wouldn't play it that often, but it was my change of pace. Alabama in a tough game right now. Alabama, they're struggling to take control of this game. All locked up, 17 apiece. Well, if that score holds up, that would what made me choose UMass? Well, back when this game came out, there were three new teams. It was UMass. It was UTSA, which Hurricane took. And then we kind of talked about that. And somebody else was doing... I'm trying to remember. I don't remember who was the third one in that mix. But we basically were like... There were like three of us. And we kind of just... decided we were going to go. Well, you know, it was mainly, I don't remember, I don't even remember who the third was, but as far as Hurricane and I, we talked quite a bit, and that was our strategy, that each one of us were going to take one of the new teams in the game and try to build them up. So he went Roadrunners, I went UMass. I'll take this all day if you're going to give it to me. This dude's a beast.
To be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line.
How far are you going to play off my receiver on that curl? I might just take that. Nope. Gonna blitz me, okay.
Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Let's see if you can cover me deep. I haven't taken a deep shot yet. I'm gonna come up and press. Ooh, I like that. I like that. Offside, maybe? Bye-bye. Oh, nice catch. He had to kind of fall and tumble to make it, but we'll take our free shot. Decline that.
So what do you think of this receiver after that play?
The quarterback made a nice throw, but it was the receiver who made this happen. That's
Texas State was the other team, yeah. What game is this? NCAA 13.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air.
I hate to bring him back into this traffic. Hey, why don't you just try to go deep?
He doesn't like what he sees. He's going to change the play here.
Oh, that could have been a pick too. Careful.
This guy drops an interception. What's ironic about that, from going to the meetings the other day, is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you
can't catch the ball as a defensive back. Let's see. We got 2nd and 10. I don't have my burner in the game right now, but God, are any of these under center? And I hate the play arc gets so messy on the screen, sometimes I can't tell. I think these are all pistol ones. Darn it.
From the 24-yard line, 2nd down.
Wow, so he has a choice to either go left or right. Craziness. Ah, there we go. They don't match up very well with my wide receivers, do they?
His 3rd toss for a score.
Fly today, and his Meadows strikes again. Great touchdown. Do I like UMass in real life? Let's put it this way. I knew nothing about the football program until this started. I started following them in real life, players like Rob Blanchflower and stuff like that. And, you know, it's kind of fun because Blanchflower will still retweet me from time to time when I throw up a video and stuff, which is fun. And let's just say they're on my radar now, and even though I don't get to see a lot of their games because they're not exactly national TV material a lot, but whenever I see them on, like, the ESPN, on their apps and stuff like that, I'll check out the games. And I definitely would say I'm more of a follower now than I ever would have been had I not done this series. So it's kind of like art imitating life, or life imitating art, whatever way that would go in that case.
And they can forget about returning this one.
What does Nodas fan stand for? Yeah. So back when I was married, which wasn't that long ago, I guess. My brother-in-law was in a band called the Nodas, and I spent a lot of time going around seeing them play, hanging out. I mean, they were basically like brothers to me, and I did some stuff for them in the early days, like back when internet, back when websites were just like HTML. Oh, got him, Chase! There you go, baby. Take it to the house. Oh. So close. So close. He got the spotlight at the start of the game. And he almost takes that one back to the house. Where are they going to mark that? He reached out for the pylon. Two guys had a chance to pick on that. Anyway, back in the day when doing websites was just HTML and stuff like that, I knew enough to mess around, and I did some early website work for them and stuff, and, you know, very rudimentary fan boards and stuff like that. So I took the username Nodas Fan for a lot of that stuff, and it just stuck in pretty much everything I did online. I don't really want this play.
Trying to change the play.
I'm gonna get caught here again, aren't I? There we go. That's what happens when I pick plays while I'm answering questions. I'm not even paying attention to the scenario here.
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
Will I put licensed equipment on my Road to the Show players? Heck yeah. There was a question in there somewhere, and I know I've answered it probably 100 times this month, but I understand not everybody sees every video I do. Or I think I put one out yesterday that was it Meyer Road to the Show? Pretty sure it was Meyer. Or was it Broadway? No, Broadway was today. Meyer was yesterday. That said, my MLB 15 plans. So those two, Meyer and Broadway, definitely will continue, because they're going to be like my legacy series. But I will do a new player also. And likewise with the franchise. I'm going to continue the Cubs franchise, but I will probably wait once again until Operation Sports rosters come out to start a brand new one. But that'll be good because the Cubs franchise can bridge that gap then until that's ready. Last year, I did hold off for the rosters, and some people were like, "Where's your franchise? Where's your franchise?" And I'm like, "Well, I always wait for the rosters, or I almost always wait for them, because I like to have all the minor leaguers set up and stuff in there, especially if it's gonna be one I'm gonna do for a while. Like, I've had a lot of fun. Otherwise, I wouldn't have had like your Chris Bryant's and your Javier Baez and Soler and all those guys. Oh, he broke off that." Nicely played, dude. That have been really important to my Cubs franchise. So, yeah. The old sprinkled in with the new is my plan. Somebody asked me, too, in a comment. I don't think I responded directly yet, but I meant to. If I was going to be telling people what I'm doing. I don't usually... If I'm making a new character or whatever, I usually don't announce that or decide that until, like the first episode of something comes out. Touchdown Auburn. So I don't usually say, this guy will be coming in 3 weeks or something like that. So, and that's usually because up until, maybe the day the game comes out, maybe the day before, I usually don't know myself. I usually decide... not necessarily right on the spot, but I don't always have a clear idea of what that character is going to be or what my franchise team is going to be until I just say, okay, here we go, and I'm going for it. What's my tip for someone starting a new dynasty in NCAA 14? Study up on the recruiting because it still has me boggled. I don't know. I have not found a way to... effectively recruit in that game unless you have a coach that's a super high rank. Got a message from Junk here. See what he's up to. Actually, I know what he's up to, but
I have a fire. Nobody wants to sit next to it for me. Or with me.
What do you smell or something, dude? I'm live streaming UMass right now. You got anything to say to the people? I probably should just be running the football right now, up 35-16. You can be sure. Gonna have a message from Junk Gaming Videos. He's drinking and sitting by the fire right now. Yeah, I'll have to get to that after the play. As soon as he sends me a message back. Oh, let's see. Let's run something we haven't run yet. It's middle read. I don't know. It looks similar to what I've been running, but who do I got coming over the middle this time? Same story, a little different flavor here. Oh! That was almost disaster.
You're asking me if I got something to say to the people when I'm fucking 10 beers in. That's not a good whatever.
10 beers, man. Lucky. Heck yeah, they're all like drunk stream.
Third down at 6 yards to go. Ball on the 32-yard line.
That's what I've been waiting for on that route the whole night. And there you go. You missed him, too. Corey Harvey off to the races. Touchdown. Have I ever played MVP baseball? Of course. At MVP baseball on my Xbox. I had it on my my PSP. Drunk junk is best junk. I agree. Right? That's so true. You may end up at WrestleMania next weekend. Awesome. Say hi to Tubby Emu. He'll be out there. I will not, but I'm thinking of going next year. I got a buddy who lives in Dallas. Why am I doing this for PAT? Yeah, I'm reading comments instead of picking plays that make sense here. Dude, we came to pound Auburn today. Chris the Dog would not approve of what is going on here right now. Not at all. He would not be a fan.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off.
I should play NASCAR. I've thought about that once in a while. If I were going to do that, like now my buddy Bob Train, like I know he's into the whole iRacing scene, and he's set up himself up an awesome setup. He's got the whole car cockpit setup, whatever you want to call it. And some of those guys get really into that. I think if I were to do NASCAR game, it would have to be like a live stream format, because I cannot see myself commentating on a NASCAR video. We get the fumble? Yeah, baby. This is just going from bad to worse. This is still third quarter, by the way. Auburn's going to want to forget this one. What do you do on a NASCAR commentary? I'm turning left. Oh, I'm turning left. No, here we go. Now I'm really turning left. I mean, you know. Maybe having 10 beers, like Junk suggested, and then just drunk streaming it, maybe. Maybe it would make sense that way. I don't know. I'm going to really try to dagger these MFers. Make them wish they hadn't made the trip here.
UMass in control.
I'm going to be honest. I don't even know who Johnson is. He's about to light it up, though. Whoa! Did he already score once? He might have. Do I play Need for Speed? I've played some of the Need for Speed games. That's another game that I play for about half hour and give up on. SGU is the best thing on YouTube. Thank you, Maddie Summers. That is very, very kind of you to say. King Matt, hey, I saw you sneak in here. How you doing? You know, with two losses already, we've got to make statements like this. So I'm not going to apologize for running up a score here. If you're going to turn the ball over. Drunk live stream would work for NASCAR. Except, I don't know. Have you guys ever seen me do racing games? Like, I did some footage when was one of the last ones that came out? Demo for Xbox One. I forget the names of them. But anyway, I did a couple videos, and the people who are actually into the racing is like, God, this guy. Like, can he not crash a car? And then the one I went particularly slow because I didn't want to crash the car. And they're like, could you have gone any slower? I'm like, okay, hi. I don't do racing games very often. I can only imagine if I were drunk, I'd be hitting the wall constantly because I already do. Do I play Clash of Clans? I do not. No, I don't get it. I don't really get into the role-playing. I've never been a World of Warcraft or anything. I've had friends that were. Definitely. So I kind of know a little bit of the culture and all that stuff. But nope, I've never really gotten sucked into those kind of like the RPGs and stuff. Which is fine because I don't got time for that. Imagine my YouTube channel would be dead if I got into something addicting like that. Just it would not be good. It would not be good. Trust me. I mean, that's the problem with, you know, every time a game like Grand Theft Auto comes out, and I'm just like, oh, yes, I got to get that. I get so excited. And it's like, I am genuinely excited to play it, but like I just said about it, you know, half hour ago, A, I don't have much time to play it, and B, when I do play it, I suck and I get frustrated. So, like, I'll just be wowed by the graphics and, you know, taken away by the stories that they got going in some of those games now. I mean, they're better than movies, if you ask me. And more fun because they're more interactive. I can't believe that guy just dropped that. But you know, when it comes down to it, I'm just not very good. And whenever I go, hey, you know, my audience would, hey, I'll get away with putting this on my channel because, you know, that way I'm still recording something and I haven't planned. Yeah, it always bombs. I mean, it's expected, but, you know, it bombs on my sports channel, obviously. So there's multiple reasons why I don't do a lot of that. Plus, there are just straight-up games. Ooh, nice catch. There's straight-up games that I bought because I thought were going to be awesome, and then just because of the time factor, are still in plastic on my shelf. I'm like, really? And I'm not one to really trade games or sell games. I really don't that often, so I usually hang on to them in case, you know, just in case, for the rainy day that I might get to sit down and say, hey, let's play through Uncharted or something. I don't know. But I always have best intentions on those kind of games. Forza Horizon, that's the one I was thinking of that I put demo stuff up. I love those kind of games. But I'm not one to play it like for hours and hours on end. I mean, like, oh, this is fun. Like, it's a fun game for me for like a half hour or an hour at a time. So, yeah. They're changing the play. So I'm thinking, guys, just while I'm thinking about this in my head, might as well get it out of there, out of my head and out to you. So my kids are going with my ex-wife on spring break. The end of next week. I believe they leave Friday. So anyway, I've got WrestleMania Sunday open. Well, besides, I gotta see a guy about getting my taxes taken care of, all that. Once I get that out of the way, Junk and I'll be hanging out. Obviously, WrestleMania. We'll probably do. I can almost guarantee you we'll be. Wow, I'm coming out with that, really? Okay, Corey Harvey, just having some fun right now. I'm sure we'll be live streaming something for WrestleMania, for fun. But what I'm getting at is baseball releases the 31st. So that's right during the week where my kids are gone. So it actually plays into my favor as far as not only getting out recorded content, a lot of you know, examples of gameplay like I always do when a game first comes out. All that good stuff. But, wow, this dude's going to set some records, man. He just keeps breaking the seam. Woo-hoo! Damn. They can't cover that route. Joel Meadows setting records for touchdown passes in a game. That's right. Still got a whole quarter left. I probably should bench him so he doesn't get hurt, but what fun is that? Jesse Johnson, 84 yards. Dog Bone Stream? Yeah, I gotta do one of those. So I guess my point was, not only will I record a lot like I always do when a game first comes out, but I think I'll have a lot of time to do some impromptu live streams, just showing off the game real well, you know, as well as I can, jumping into some modes. I'm really excited to see what Diamond Dynasty is like this year because I know it's focused more so now on the Major League collections as it should have been the whole time. I don't know what they were doing with all the fake people in that. I like how you get one guy, though, that recycles into, you know, you got one fake guy you build up and he can play at any position, and you can basically recycle your extra cards into that guy. So, I mean, I like the premise better, so you might see a longer-running Diamond Dynasty thing for me. I still wish that you could play your friends in it, and it's probably not going to happen. Here's a message from Junk.
This is hard to do when you've been drinking. All I know, these people want to see an interesting edit. They just need to watch this one because, yeah, it's fucked up.
Are you drunk editing Jackhammer right now? Oh my goodness, dude. He's drunk editing a Jackhammer episode. He's going to put clips in there 2-3 times. I can see it happening now. On the positive, you'll probably get a dual com from us for Jackhammer tomorrow. He'll probably send that over in the Dropbox.
boy Jammer's playing. I think he's fucking drunk.
Yes.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
You know, they can have that short yardage stuff all they want. I mean, that's fine. I'm not going to stop them from that. I just don't want to get beat deep.
Drops back to pass. He's scrambling.
This running with the quarterback's kind of making me mad, though, because I feel like we should know that's coming already. But then again, I'm not putting a spy on him, so I guess that's my fault.
He drops back.
How'd he get through there? Come on. Oh, he got drilled. He got drilled. Another message from Junk incoming.
If you see scene more than once, then you know, yeah, he was drunk.
A lot of plays in the running game.
That's what I just said in the thing. I'm like, we're going to see the same scene 2-3 times in a row.
This offense do anything to slow down this pass rush.
I think they need to make some adjustments with their pass protection. Maybe allow
this guy got lit up on this play. He got hurt once earlier, which is kind of crazy. They're still running him a lot. Now they got a guy out, strained tricep. Man, they got a first down there.
I haven't had 10 beers, so I literally had 8 or something.
First down and back to pass. Now he tries to buy some time. And he's taken down around the 20.
I haven't had 10 beers, so I literally had 8 or something.
Are you still entertaining? Oh, he's hurt again.
So it's second down, about 2 yards to go. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals.
Oh, they set up the screen pretty well, too.
A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. First and goal. We'll wait and see here if he really does change.
Nope, nothing there.
Get him in the backfield for a loss.
Okay, why would I tell people to subscribe to your channel if you have zero people? Do you have videos?
Second and goal. Ball on the 13-yard line.
Usually if I tell people to subscribe somewhere, it's because there's like good quality content to check out. I mean, I'm not saying you don't, but if you have zero people subscribe, you can figure out the rest. What did he just say?
If I was entertaining, I wouldn't be putting this fucking crappy-ass baseball episode together.
There you go, folks. You got a awesome preview of what's coming out tomorrow. A crappy ass video. Ha ha. Yeah, why would you want me to tell people to come sub to you? I mean, that would just be dead subs, you know? You want people to come sub to you because they like your content and they want to come back. I mean, what's the point of telling someone to come there?
Steps up in the pocket.
Oh, really? Really now? You're going to... Oh, I thought about going all the way, but he wasn't going to let me. I mean, you know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to be, you know, mean or anything. I'm just saying, I got all my subs because I put out content and people started to find that little by little. It's not an overnight thing. And, I mean, trust me. When they show up, you want there to be something good there for them to come back for. Got to build a base and hit that up. I I set Houston up to get destroyed there.
He's tackled at about the 25-yard line. Houston picks up about 5 yards on that hookup. That brings
up second and five. You heard it here first, folks. Nothing but the best from Junk on this channel. Man, I hate this. It's like, it's been weeks of this where it's, I don't have a full-blown cold, but it's always something like just a touch of a cough or touch of congestion. It's annoying. I'm just ready to be done with all the crud. And oh, they've had a couple chances to pick me off that they have not followed through on. And then I just say, okay, let's go ahead and burn you again. Should you go to the hospital if you have pressure in your chest? Maybe.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide
depends on how bad that is, I guess. Oh, I just let him too far. This will be our first punt since the first punt. The one they fumbled. Oh, boy. Are we having trouble in the chat?
Carter is back to receive.
Let's play nice now.
Oh, excellent punt.
Well, they hung on to this one.
To about the 34-yard line.
So they got that going for them.
Has made a statement with his play tonight.
This is one of those performances that the guys back in the studio in Bristol are going to be talking about all night.
I wouldn't say the defense has played great, but, you know, I mean, we've put them in a position to succeed being up so far here. And they did have the pick. It almost went back for a pick six. And they forced a turnover on a fumble. And I mean, we are playing Auburn. They're not ranked, but they're Auburn, so.
But that being said, we could still see some.
You viewed a live stream of mine from the ER before? Oh, man. I mean, that's flattering that, man, I know how it can suck, like, too, hanging out in the ER, like, for hours on end, it seems like, even when it's not. So, I mean, I'm flattered you'd choose me to help you pass the time on something like that. That's kind of a cool thing. I really appreciate that. But that sucks, man, if you're in the ER a lot.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 45.
I guess I didn't see Noob's original comment, but I
takes it up the middle for
a nice. Now I got to read this. No, I'm not. I am not black. No. I am
just under three to go.
I am painfully white. Let me say. I'm
back to pass. He scrambled.
You'd be blinded by me.
Watch out. Slides down.
At the beach, let's put it that way. Renegade. Ooh. I like the sound of that. I'm not picking it though.
And it looks like they're gonna change it up here.
Interesting little screen right there.
He's tackled at the 30-yard line. Morris was the intended receiver on the play.
Do I play NHL 15? I do. I have a Wild Be a GM series on my channel. You should check it out.
On the run, right side. Nice run to the outside.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got.
Do I play Grand Theft Auto? Well, yeah. Like I said, I. I guess you could say I play it. I love games like that, and you know I buy them and with every intention to play them a lot. And yeah, they more than often sit on my shelf because I'm usually recording.
Could they get another interception here? That's what they got last time this offense.
Doesn't mean I don't like him, though. I love games like that.
Scrambling around.
Wow, dude. He just...
And he is
he's kind of crafty there. He kind of sits behind his blockers. Waiting for something to open up here. Although he's been knocked out of the game twice already. Did I play baseball as a kid? Yes, I certainly did. It's funny, I was just going through a box yesterday. I was up in my garage here at my apartment, and I found my all my Babe Ruth pictures. Like, yes. Back in the day. It's fun.
Scott gets the call. Well, they're not going to win it, but they're still playing hard out there.
When you're that close to the end zone...
Matt, you need a tan? Yeah, I did the whole tanning thing when I was in fourth grade, going on a trip to Hawaii. I wasn't very fond of the tanning beds. Let's just say that. What I need to do is just avoid burning, because I will do that very quickly. I was always told way too often when I was married, put the sunscreen on by my sometimes nagging wife. And I think I probably didn't do it just because she told me to. But wouldn't you know, I go on a trip all by myself last year. Oh, I put that sunscreen on, and I did not get burned. Wait, why are we... Well, okay, why are you telling me how to do an onside kick recovery? I'm playing on... I don't know if it's because I haven't been on here a lot of times. God, what, seriously, you're telling me how to do an onside... Whatever. Like, when did coaches' tips get enabled again? You know, that same thing will happen, like, on the PS4 when we're doing, like, our Madden stuff. We're playing on all Madden, but Junk will come over here, and even though he's played his games on my system forever, you know, he'll log in, and all of a sudden, like, all the coaches' tutorials pop up, like, all the, like, the first, you know, that first screen of Madden where you got to do the Cam Newton thing? That thing will pop up on him once in a while. It's like, dude, it's like he's played the game before. Why does it keep doing this to him? Okay, like it all of a sudden starts considering him a new user and stuff. I guess my 360. Like I said, I had to go replace batteries because I'm like, I haven't played my 360 in a while in here. why am I still wanting to open up a can of whoop ass on these guys? I don't know. I just do.
The stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game.
It's Wesley going over the middle this time.
And he might change the play here before the snap.
Oh, they finally did pick me. I didn't see that, dude. I was worried about the guy closing back on the curl, and instead, they just dropped a backer in front of that. Well, you're welcome. You're welcome. Take it. Matt, you sound like you're 30. Well, I'm actually 38.
Just under 2 minutes in the game.
So, thank you.
He drops the throw on first down, and he hits him hard at the 46-yard line.
How about the big fellas up front?
Give you tips on starting a series. Well, pick something that you feel like you're going to stick with for a while, that you can actually feel that you can get excited about playing.
That could be a check.
Because, you know, when you go out to set that series out there, you want to actually sound enthusiastic about it. You don't want to go, okay, I'm playing football today, my team sucks, I don't care. You know, you want to get into something that you can feel that you can buy into this. Like, I always try to make mine a little more than really what's there. It's like this series. You know, I mean, we got a guy out for the game, Bruce Sternum. That sucks. Especially in mop-up time here. This and other series, you know, you want to kind of create storylines that might not even be there if you can. Like, create something a little more for people to hang on to. You know, it's like the whole Cam Slinger thing and how we were trying to recruit him early on in the first year and he said no. Well, you know, I didn't tell the game to put him in the national championship against me, but I sure as hell played that up when that came around. So, you know, just finding little things that you can kind of make the series your own, a personal touch to, will go a long way. And just enthusiasm, you know, buy into what you're doing. Because, trust me, I've played series that I weren't, you know, that I'm like, I kind of just went through the motions on, and I didn't really feel that excited about it. And people would tell me, I get the feedback, like, you know, maybe you shouldn't just play this one because you're just not feeling it. Like, certain times with Madden and their career mode before they went to the connected franchise stuff, I mean, it's still very rough at times. But, you know, the times there would be so broken, and I just would, most of my videos would end up with a rant on it, and they'd be like, you know, people could tell I just wasn't into it. So, You know, and I would say, I mean, I'm proof that you don't have to be very good at these games, because I'm not. I'm not very good at these games at all. But I have a lot of fun playing them, and I have a lot of fun telling stories within the careers and within the franchises and dynasties and stuff. And I think, I mean, to me, YouTube is more about entertaining than it is about. I mean, I could see if you're if you're some kind of an MLG pro, and I mean that's what you do is play competitive, then I can understand, that's the kind of look at how good I am kind of thing. Well, I'm not look at how good I am. I'm just like, hey, I'm playing this. I want you to buy into this franchise that I'm doing. I want you to feel for the players and those kind of things. So, I mean, that's what I focus on. And I play too many games within the sports, like, to be very good at any of them. Like, guys that'll, oh, here we go. We got the pick. Oh, I wish he could have stayed in bounds. Some of these guys will be just mutt guys or be just hockey or whatever. And that's a little too much for me. Like, I think I'd burn out quickly if I did it that way. So I love the variety, but unfortunately it also means that I don't, like, master any one game that I play. And I know that I probably should just take a knee here, but and I know some people, like, especially when you play people online, that's why I don't play a whole lot of online games in Madden or anything like that. Like, I know some people will treat it as a video game and win at all costs, more so than a game. And I'm thinking football. Okay, I'm playing football. This is how football should be played. I'm going to play, in a somewhat of a correct manner instead of, okay, well, maybe I could beat you going every fourth down and all that stuff, but I don't want to do that. So, I mean, I kind of look at things with a different perspective than some. If I were out there trying to climb leaderboards and things like that, and if that were my end game, it'd be a lot different.
And so that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, UMass 56, Auburn 26. The Tigers 26. As we take a look at the highlights, Kirk, how would you summarize the action in this one?
Well, I think all right, our play of the game. That was a heck of a play. What was that, 84 yards, something like that?
Too much about what their opponent was going to do and not executing their own game plan. Once they fell behind, they really seemed to lose.
All right, so we've been going for about an hour and a half. Yikes. Okay, so can I do an updated video on what your house looks like? Well, it's actually an apartment, and it's kind of messy right now, but kids kind of destroy things from time to time. Yeah, I'll probably do that at some point.
Here's a look at today's player.
I'm to the point where I really do like my office setup. I'm staring at five screens right now. Four of them, well, three of them, which are actually involved in what I'm doing right now. One I'm watching games on, but I don't know why. Okay, ever since this hockey ended, I just left it on Big Ten Network. I should have switched back to the tourney here. Get Butler Notre Dame on. Or is that game almost over? What year is this game? This is NCAA 13. So I will do a quick run through of my recruiting here before I take off. Butler now leads Notre Dame. Okay. Man, a lot of highlights in this one. Highlight reel just keeps running and running and running and running. But that's cool. Yep, Villanova is gone. Am I stopping? No, I'm gonna do my recruiting, but then I'll be stopping. I don't want these to go much more than a 2-hour stream. What are my kids' names? Coleman and Kylie. I thought Iowa State would go far. So did I. I had them in the Final Four. Can you make these videos more? You know, I have every intention to do this more often. That's why I brought it back. But it really lends itself well to a night like this when I don't have the kids and I don't have... I mean, let's just face it, you know. Being a dad takes a lot of time, right? If you do it right. Especially on a school night where you got to get them ready and get lunches made and make sure they've had baths and get to bed and make sure you're doing everything right. So, I mean, it works out better when I've got a night that, you know, I do end up with quite a lot of nights like this. I guess you'd say half the time. I try to stay busy. Junk and I do a lot of stuff. Tubby Emu was here for a couple weeks hanging out. We were doing a bunch of stuff. I got a lot of Timberwolves games during the week. My family, my dad's got season tickets, and he can't make the weeknight games, so I go to a lot of those. But, you know, when I have a night when there's really nothing other going on than just editing videos and sitting around and watching the tourney and stuff like this, it makes for a good time to stream something like this. I should get the kids on stream? Yeah, they're not here right now. They are... I don't know, what do you call Mrs. Not His Fan now that we're not married? They're with ex-Mrs. Not His Fan. Whatever. The following prospects were scheduled to visit this campus this week. Oh, well, that was a good time because we put a hurting on those dudes. Look at all those guys we had come in. Oh, my God. Okay, that means we got to be very careful here setting up their visit, like what they're going to... Oh, this guy's a soft at Clemson. Whatever, he's visiting. Maybe I've never actually stolen someone on that situation, but let's see here. Got to set his activities. Got to hit the very highs and the high. There we go. I'm just going to set up all the activities first so I don't forget. Very high. I got to be average on those. Come on. Most, very high, high. Love it. Okay. Although he's already a soft to Clemson. High, very high. Most is a D plus. That sucks, though. I guess we gotta go with the average. Guess I could wait and see if I sway him on something, but... Very high, high. Very high, okay. Oh yeah, it's a pretty good game here, Butler, Notre Dame. See, I liked recruiting a lot better back in this game. I felt like I had a little bit of a connection to each guy, at least learning what their likes and dislikes were and stuff, and like it just felt so much NCAA 14 feels so much just like it's just moving numbers around a spreadsheet. It is still... Whoa. That's not what I wanted to do. Your voice is annoying. Well, sorry. There is always an option to just not watch the video, dude. I have no idea what these guys' likes are. Above average, average. Actually, don't do the average. Do the above average. There we go. What do I think about NC State in the Sweet 16? Yeah, did a good job knocking off Villanova. Villanova out of the number ones, I guess I must have looked at it as one of the weakest ones because I had them losing. I had them going to the Sweet 16, but then losing. But then again, I had Iowa State in the Final Four, so what do I know? Did I do this guy already? Yup. This is a lot of visits all on the same day. I'm glad we won. I don't know how well that plays in, but I'm still glad we won. And I really should be finding out on some of these guys. that I haven't asked them questions what their likes and dislikes are, but some of these I just don't care because they're not high enough rated. This dude is, though. Most. We have a bunch more that want visits, so I guess we gotta look at that too. But obviously I'm focused on, he's fourth. Let's see. We don't have much of a shot at this dude, but that doesn't mean I'm not taking a shot at him. Weight him to average there. Let's see what else. Made promises, scholarship offer. Give him his choice. Okay.
Yeah, that's the plan.
This guy's first. Gotta make sure we hammer him. Take all these points away from Clemson where we can. Try to sway that. Nope. Weigh that to average. Couldn't sway that. Still pretty good if we're in the lead. We're fine with that. This guy's up to third, but he's a soft Clemson. This probably isn't going to happen, but he's visiting. We'll hit it one more time. Oh, I got to remember to use my scouting time too. Ah, what the heck. Go big or go home. We'll get the other guys later. Hit these points big. Take a home run swing. Why is it us and Clemson going after everybody? Got that up to average. Least. I don't think he's going to come off a least, is he? Nope. Kind of a wasted deal right there. He's low on that, too. Probably not going to change his mind, but whatever. Hold up a sec. Yeah, okay. Gotta secure our future at quarterback here. Wait, where do we rank on him? Oh, we are first with him. I'm looking for a spot where we actually have an advantage on Oregon here. There we go. And again. Get that up to average. see what he thinks. Oh, very high on that. Okay, good to know. If you don't shout me out, I'm leaving. Bye! I don't do threats. Sorry, you'll learn that quick about me. Oh, I still have promises for this guy. You're 78 overall, 100% scouted. I guess I can probably say it sucks not saying no redshirt anymore because I am kind of starting to get loaded these years, but that's okay. We'll give him that if it puts him over. Oh, this guy's decided between us and Auburn. And, oh, did he have a visit? Oh, boy. I would hope that that should have made us mind up right there if he was at this game. Like big time. No, Hurricane and I are not the same age. Nope. You know, once again, if it's boring, you know, feel free to go. No one's holding the gun to you. Had to stay here. This right here is for the people who know and love this series. And it's for them. If you're bored, you can go. I did his activities, okay. This guy ranks 78, and he's fourth. He's not solid on anybody yet, though. He's the number one tackle, and we're going after him. I'm focusing heavy on the top of my board. I honestly don't really care, you know, if I... These guys that are lower rated, I could probably scoop them up later anyway. No one likes this series. Yep, you're right. You're right. No one likes this series. They never did. What a clown. What a clown you are. Yeah, I'm a little biased when it comes to Iowa State because I spent a lot of time in Ames watching the Nottas. That's where they all met at Iowa State names. And so I always tend to overvalue Iowa State when they get in the tourney a little bit, and it cost me this time. I thought they'd really make a run this year. But oh well. Yeah, I don't know if we're getting back in on this guy or not. What else we got? We got some higher rated guys down here. Oh, not too bad. Wait, this dude's 79? Okay, here's where I gotta use my scouting. Oh, he's just about decided anyway. See if this guy stays the real deal here or not. His agility's up. It's catching's down. And he stayed pretty good. 78 at 100%. I don't know if we really got a shot at him, though. What's this deal? What's this guy's deal? 76. I got to scout this guy more, too. +3. Okay, there we go. And he's first. Yeah, that might just work out nicely here. Gonna bump him up our board so we pay attention. Might have found ourselves something. So we need to... We didn't even offer this dude a scholarship. He just kind of hung around. Dang, okay. Probably don't need to put in this much time. I made him a couple promises already. Let's go ahead and offer him that scholarship. I was hoping maybe he'd just say yes on the spot. Might as well find out his importance, what he thinks about these since he's going to be visiting. Open up as many of these as we can. At least in the categories that matter. All right. He kind of came out of nowhere. That was pretty decent. Who else needs to be scouted here? This guy. Athletes take the most to open up the scouting. What's my YouTube name? You're on my YouTube channel right now. What are you talking about? Maybe you're being sarcastic. I don't know. Like, I'm kind of scratching my head at that one. You should always redshirt on their junior year. Yeah, I know, it's kind of funny because, like, a college in their right mind would never do something like that. But in video game land, that makes sense. I know what you're saying. And then you get away from that promise of, okay, so I won't redshirt you as a freshman. Well, I might redshirt you later. Yep, I've done some things like that with quarterbacks. All right, so I got to do a reset here. What am I looking at? Okay, I've only got 10 minutes of scouting left. Ooh, I probably won't get to 100 on him. No, I did. I did get to 100 on him. Okay, might have another bit of a gem here. And he's coming to visit, too. Okay, so I need to find out some things on him and then change what I'm doing with him. Let's find out what he thinks about these. Above average, good. Need to know that. High, good. I got something to work with. Let's sway him here. Nope. I don't care about these ones we're not good in because I'm not going to pick those anyway. Ah, he's not going to be swayed. Okay. Very high in that. All right. Now I got to go in and change what we're going to focus on with him. Above average, most, high. No, I had it set up pretty good already. All right, 2 hours left of recruiting. Let's just get it done here. I honestly don't think we're going to get back in the race for this guy. Take a couple stabs here randomly at some of these guys. I don't want to overthink it right now. This guy's still very much at play. Care about that very much. Average on that. High right there. Low on that. Haven't offered this dude a scholarship at 77 overall at 100%. Go ahead and offer that. Okay, 30 minutes left. I already hit him up, that's right. We're first on this guy's list, let's talk to him. He's low on everything so far. That's not good. Oh, very high right there. Okay. So that's going to kill my recruiting. We'll advance the week, see what our ranking is after that thrashing of Auburn. Got this almost at the two-hour mark. I'm hoping I can cut that first 5 minutes out because, whatever, the first 5-7 minutes that we didn't have audio. Because that's going to kind of suck as a video later if I can't do that. But whatever. Okay, so we'll advance the week. Looks like this comment section's gone to hell pretty much. Some bored people. Not all of you, of course. Oh, we have a bye week coming up, which means just more recruiting. I don't think I'm going to do that right now, though. Because I've got editing and stuff I want to get done. So I can get that Cubs video up tomorrow. What's this mode? This is Dynasty. In NCAA 13, year 6 now of this long-running UMass dynasty. We just did our recruiting there. My beer of choice. Ah, depends on the day. I've long been a Guinness drinker. I like dark beers a lot of times. I like stouts. I've been big into like coffee beers lately, but really I'm all across the board. I'll pretty much drink what's around with the exception of, I'm really not a fan of like your Miller Lights, Bud Lights, that kind of stuff. I mean, I really like craft beers. I like trying something new. I tried one, We got a place that's new by us called the New Belgium. I mean, I know it's a chain. I don't know outside of Minnesota. There's a couple around here. Ooh, we got the halfback, Peterson. Nice. We'll take that. But this New Belgium, you know, it's one of those places where they got like 30 crafts on tap, and then they rotate weekly or daily or whatever. But I tried one, and God, I cannot remember the name of it, but it was legit 17% alcohol. I'm like, oh, okay. It actually had, I mean, it had a heck of a, it kicked me in the ass, that's for sure, but it definitely had a nice taste to it. So we are now number 8 going into our bye week. Look at the polls really quick. Michigan's your number 1 team. Michigan State with Cam Slinger in his final season there at number 2. Wow. That'll never happen because they're both in the Big Ten. But can you imagine a championship game there? Look at that. Your top 3 are Big Ten teams. That's never going to last because they're all going to take each other on at some point. But, yeah. So as far as your unbeatens, Miami, then Boise. We still got a fighting chance in this, maybe. Let's see. So, all right. I think that's where I'm gonna call it. I don't know if I'll probably do the bye week recruiting before I do the next live stream, but we'll see. I don't really usually like to kick off with recruiting. But I want this to stay under 2 hours. So I think I'm going to call it here. Thanks for joining me, guys, for more UMass. It's been fun as always. And I will catch you next time around. Have a great, Saturday night, Sunday morning, whatever it is for you and your time zone. Keep watching that tourney. We'll talk to you soon. Junk and I will be hitting you with some live streams tomorrow. Probably our wrestling universe mode, among other things. All right, we'll see you later.